And I'm here today to talk to you about an article that's in this month's AJM that I think is really interesting. The lead author is from Wayne State Medical School in Detroit, and it's a sort of composite analysis of many, many studies on the effects of malnutrition on patients who come in with sepsis. Now, you might expect that if you were malnourished and you got any illness, it would not be a good thing. And that's exactly what this article showed. You can pretty much tell nutrition status of patients. First of all, sometimes just looking at them, seeing if they look thin and wasted. But in fact, the biochemistry is very helpful. These folks have very low albumin, very low cholesterol. It's not often they're anemic. It's usually not difficult to tell that they're not eating very well. And often the history helps you. They tell you, I'm just eating one meal a day. This is particularly common in some of our senior geriatric patients who it's difficult to get out and get food for their home. In any case, as you might imagine, if you had sepsis and you were malnourished, you did much worse than patients who were well-nourished. This kind of information has been found with a whole variety of illnesses. When you're malnourished, your immune system doesn't work so well. Your physiology is also impaired. This is further support for the idea that nutrition is really important. And these days when I'm doing the internal medicine inpatient rounds, I'm always asking the patients, how many meals are you eating a day and who gets your food? And then we try and figure out a way to get some kind of home health assistance for the older folks who really don't get out anymore and who are often eating what I learned as a resident, it was called the tea and toast diet. That's obviously not good for you. Thanks very much for reading the AJM, and look forward to seeing you reading our website or our Facebook or our Twitter accounts.